that our returning back to Parliament for this second session, we are coming energized.
The 11th Parliament resumes business tomorrow after a month-long recess, which started at the end of the first session. As the second session starts tomorrow, legislators believe it's time to work, having spent the first session learning how to execute parliamentary business.
Remember that we had just passed the budget, and the key on that budget that we passed as part of our appropriation is parish development model. Across the country, members of parliament, ministers, His Excellency the President, everyone has been very busy in trying to see that we come back energized to push for deliverables, for output in terms of the next appropriation that we have rolled out.
So Ugandans should expect the best from us. We are more refreshed. We have learned a lot. We have been interacting with our constituents. So we are very optimistic. We want to present what our people have sent us to say in terms of even legislation.
While opening the second session of Parliament on 7th June, President Yoweri Museveni promised 60 government bills in offing to be tabled before Parliament this season. As some legislators urge the government to expedite these bills, others are committed to move faster with private members' bills, which the government has not given much attention.
We need a standards emissions bill to know how to cater for the environment. Then we also need, we are thinking, and I'm thinking hard about bringing an amendment in the constitution where ministers are not members of parliament because of conflict of interest.
MPs have vowed to put an end to the strike of arts teachers, which started 4 weeks back, and other related issues that are putting the country at tenterhooks.
The teachers of humanities, And we feel for them, you know, when their colleagues are being paid handsomely, and for them, I know government is really trying to handle the matter. We feel for them.
And it seems that the strike may not end with only teachers. Even other sectors are in the same line. They are planning to strike. So how are we going to address it as parliament? Is it that parliament should sit and we pass a supplementary? Or we have to find a way how we can convince these people to go and work for government until when money is got.
As the sessions begin, renewal of membership and leadership of sectional committees is business number one, and the battle for Jewish committees is currently activated. According to the vice chairperson of ANRM Parliamentary Caucus, Herbert Chinobero, those who did not perform to expectations should not expect to retain chairmanship of their committees.
Their committee chairperson is who go for activities, but writing a report is a problem. You ask them to get your report and present on the floor, you can't find them. So such a member or such a leader is not a performer.
This has sent panic amongst those who chaired and vice-chaired sectoral committees in the first session, wondering what scale of performance will be used. Yet committee work was generally frustrated by poor facilitation in the first session.
I cannot hold any committee responsible for bad performance, because all committees were actually affected by the low funding, or actually budget cuts from the Minister of Finance.
For you to assess whether someone has performed, you needed to have given them the tools and the resources to perform the task that is before them.
Most chairpersons believe they performed very well in their mandate and they deserve to be retained by their political party leadership.
And as a committee, in my view, we have performed what was expected of us. And I wouldn't see any reason, unless for other reasons, but for purposes of performance, in my view, our committee has performed to the expectations, and it's my expectation that the members and the leadership is maintained.
Not chairpersons alone, MPs are also at stance to secure sectoral committees suitable for their aspirations.
I'm more of a diplomatic person. It suits my kind of character. And I want to persuade the government to improve on the relationship Uganda has with other diplomatic missions.
According to the order paper released today, designation of sectoral committee members is item number 5 in tomorrow's sitting. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.